We have a really, really super practice today. A super practice, the most intense ever, as we turn the corner into this new perspective that we have hope that it's going to be sufficient to offset what's going on in the world. I remember back in the 60s, the 70s, the 80s, struggling with that time then, and the spiritual teaching of those times, it didn't seem to work for me. It didn't seem to work. It didn't work. And so I'm not going to just continue to focus on what hasn't worked in the past for me. I'm going to take this very wonderful new perspective. This perspective, I don't want to repeat what hasn't worked. This insanity, trying the same old thing and expecting different results. Fortunately, we have something that's different than the traditional spiritual teaching. It certainly is different. A lot of credit to A Course in Miracles that came out. I started that in 1978. That was after about 10 years of hell that went through, where spiritual teachings just couldn't lift me out of that hell at all. And A Course in Miracles gradually lifted me out of this. But we're going beyond A Course in Miracles, actually, in some ways. But there's a lot of similarities there. We're not trying to be similar. It just so happens that I found a lot of, wonderful, helpful truth there that hasn't really been talked about too much. The most important one is that this universe is our own dream. It's our own pretending. I call it pretending. He calls it an illusion. Jesus said, God is not the architect of universes, is not responsible for this universe. That is very, very different than historical teachings, extremely different. All other teachings say that God is the creator of this universe, so we need to praise this universe, praise God for this universe, and learn how to function here and various stuff. And it's just, he's in control of every last little thing that happens here. God is there. And Jesus says, no, he doesn't even know that this universe exists, so to speak. It's not the architect of universes at all. And so this is quite, quite different. So this is a really hopeful avenue that we have here, that we've gone even, we've sort of streamlined the whole thing and been able to make some additional breakthroughs and clarifications from almost 44 years of studying A Course in Miracles and tremendous familiarity with it. That out of that comes an ability to go a little further, actually. And this is what we're doing. We're turning the corner on a new perspective. And on this perspective, we're praising ourselves. We're praising ourselves and no condemnation towards anything. No, zero condemnation towards anyone. How about that? Zero condemnation. But just praise, absolute praise, just universal blanket praising of all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity-fearing wow. Okay? So this is this wonderful new perspective we have. So just accepting universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity-fearing wow. So this expresses our perspective extremely well. This is a really wonderful way to express where we're at in terms of what we believe is going to be most effective to save us from the world, but also these times that we're in, which are very nerve-wracking. If we can feel the overall what's going on in the world, it's nerve-wracking. So just delighting in universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fear. Wow. Exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fear. So the way that we've been trying to solve our continuity fear, and by the way, what continuity fear is the belief that our fear that if we stop pretending, we won't know how to function at all. So it's a fear of non-functionality, which is dreadful fear. So by our own efforts, we can't really solve this continuity fear problem. I mean, theoretically, we can drop it completely, but pragmatically, we really can't resolve it. It's too severe. So the Holy Spirit resolves it for us. It gives us we accept the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. And don't try to solve it. If we try to solve it, we're going to get entangled in all sorts of horrible situations that don't work. The fear is so severe, we underestimate it at our peril. That is for sure. Most people don't even realize we have a continuity fear. They keep thinking, well, this is, you know, I'm a human. This world is my home. Functioning here is my natural self, that identity. That's it. And so what's the big deal? None of that's true at all. This world is like a role we're playing. We're acting. This whole universe is an act we're putting on. It's performance art. This whole world is performance arting. Wow. Just life-suffering performance arting. Wow. Is what it really is. This entire universe is just life suffering performance arting. Wow, we're acting. This is all an act. This whole universe is just an act, actually, designed to convince the prime creator it needs to self-destruct because it became incapacitated and it's causing all sorts of problems and needs to self-destruct, which is not true. That's the attribution error. So we are so used to pretending that we feel if we stop, we won't know how to function in reality effortlessly, spontaneously, without any pretense whatsoever. We feel like, how can we do that? It seems impossible. So trying to come up with our own remedy for it, we just struggle and futilely. You know, it's just like trying to swim across the Pacific Ocean freestyle. You know, just swimming. It's too far of an ocean. So, but the Holy Spirit has had a remedy from the very beginning, knowing this would happen. God knew this would happen. Prime Creator knew this would happen. And so the remedy is just being there waiting for us. So we accept the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing, right? So just loving, universal, blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. So this really presents where we're at here. And this is different than the spirituality that's come before. No question about it. Like I went through the difficult times, a decade there, and it didn't work. The traditional spirituality didn't work for me, did not work for me. So I'm not going to lean on it and expect it to work for me as we go through this 10-year period we're in right now, which is an extremely trying period and will be for everybody here. Make no mistake about that. Just like 68 to 78 was an extremely difficult period in the world. This is even worse. 2020 to 2030 is like four times as bad. So certainly there are plenty of people in the world I know that are overloaded already and are suffering from depression, suicidal thoughts, and just overwhelmed already. Okay, we're just getting into it. It's just like, wow. So there has to be a new vision, a new perspective that gives people really hope. And our perspective is just universal blanket praising because everything that we have done with this universe, this performance arting, has been done with the best of intentions, really. And the attribution error was a mistake of over-adventurousness and it crossed expectations, and we made this attribution mistake instead of saying that the prime creator is incapacitated because it can't give us this rich, wonderful experience of being prior to the prime creator. It's just this smooth blankness, and that shocked us. We said, wow, the prime creator has suddenly died. You know, something became incapacitated. This is horrible. This is horrible. What can we do? We got to get rid of it. So that was just an honest mistake, you might say, on our part. We there's nothing to condemn ourselves for there, and then we never could see continuity fear coming. We could never have seen that. It's impossible. We've never pretended before at all. How could we know what pretending is like and see that we would get stuck in that? There's no way we could have seen that coming. So it built up, this continuity fear has built up in us. We honest mistake. We had no idea this would happen, and then we underestimate the severity of it severely. That again is an honest mistake, and so we try false hope habits that don't work, that's just an honest mistake as well. So really, there's no reason to condemn ourselves whatsoever. Nobody should condemn themselves at all. In fact, they should praise themselves 100%, just universal blanket praising of all pretending, here, there, everywhere, past, present, future. Wow. Okay. Oh, somebody's making a delivery. I think that might be here. I've only been waiting for it for a long, long time. Yeah. We'll see. Could it be? Could it be? Could it be? Anyway, yeah. Maybe it's something a little present for Labor Day. I hope so. Well, what can I do? I just have to keep waiting. So we praise ourselves here. We confess our mistakes and praise ourselves, okay? Both of those. So it's kind of a confessional praise approach. How about that? Isn't that amazing? Have we ever heard anything like this? Well, yeah, kind of. I mean, there's been various iterations of this, I guess. It's a confessional praise approach. We confess attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. And then we praise ourselves just delighting in universal blanket praising of all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Oh, I did not get anything. What? Come on. That's disappointing. And so there you go. Confessional praising approach. A confessional praising approach. Isn't that amazing? Isn't this amazing? Isn't this wonderful? It's like a celebration here, actually. We have this confessional praising approach. So we confess and we praise. We confess and we praise. We confess and we praise. How about that? Yeah, so I'm not about to present the old teachings that people are used to and familiar with, because for me, they didn't work. Again, they did not work. For most people, they didn't work. They didn't work well. And we're in such a bad situation in the world right now. We have to have something that's fresh, that's vital, that gives us, much more powerful hope, and that's been put in a stronger context, I would say. And we have that here, this confessional praising approach. Wow. Just confessing continuity fear, attribution error, and false hope habiting, and just accepting universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. How about that? How about that for a wonderful treat here as we go into this, the last third of this year, September, October, November, December, last 4 months, last third of this year, which is likely to be very nerve-wracking, actually. Geopolitically, just as far as our how safe we feel, how secure our future feels, all sorts of psychological, intense, big psychological stuff. It's going to be very nerve-wracking. So we counter this with this confessional praising style that we have. This confessional praising style. Isn't that wonderful? Yeah, I love it. Just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. And loving universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Just like that. So you might try working on this so that you can actually say this to yourself, and you'll impress yourself by doing this. That is for sure. So here, progress is based on impressing ourselves, not impressing on anyone else, really, but impressing ourselves. That's what really counts. That's what really, really counts. When you actually impress yourself, you don't need anybody else's approval. You see, you don't need anyone else's approval. You say, hey, I impressed myself, so it doesn't really matter what anybody else says. It doesn't really matter. And so that's what's crucial. So in order to impress yourself, you have to actually do your homework and do something that's difficult and succeed at it. And that's how you impress yourself here. So just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hopes habiting, wow, and accepting universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing, wow. And I'll write this down below the video so you can study it. You can take a picture of it on your phone so you can practice it. And just practice it. Practice it till you get it. And when you do that, you'd say, wow. You know, that's an extremely helpful step to start, you know, getting familiar with this confessional praising approach that we have. Confessional praising approach here, which is feels, you know, quite different than what we've used to probably. But it also has this feeling like, wow, this could be extremely helpful, actually. This could be extremely helpful. There's kind of this balance between saying, yeah, we made mistakes, but we're not condemning ourselves at all. We're praising ourselves. Honest mistakes, unforeseeable mistakes, no condemnation of anywhere. Everyone is just doing the best that they see based on this continuity fear now. Everybody is desperately trying to resolve that in some way and also sort of hedging their bets by also still trying to figure out a way to get the prime creator to self-destruct. So we believe we can remove an incapacitated prime creator. And so they're just everyone's struggling under this heavy, 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 heavy burden, right? And so everyone is doing what they see is their best. And it may seem odd what they're doing, you know, but it's really no reason for condemnation. We should praise all efforts here. Absolutely universal blanket praising of all pretending. Okay, of all pretending. And this will become apparent as we go along. I'm pretty clear about it, that everyone's actually, we're all divine, and we're acting in very noble fashion, even though it seems that we're trying, you know, rather very bizarre stuff. Suffering of all types and misery of all types, but that again is designed with a purpose in mind to try and bring about, you know, either a remedy for the attribution error or the remedy for the continuity fear. We're working on one or the other of those mostly, but and then even when we're working on the continuity fear, there's still remnants of the attribution error still going in our scripting, in our what we're working on, that still influences. We're still under the influence of the attribution error, but less and less as we work more on the continuity first. So just confess and praise confess and praise. Wow, just loving confession, confessing and praising. Wow, just loving confessing and praising. Wow, just shocked by confessing and praising. Wow, just allowing confessing and praising. Wow, just accepting confessing and praising. Wow, just delighting in confessing and praising. Wow. Just loving, confessing, and praising. Wow. Just abiding in confessing and praising. Wow. Just confessing and praising. Wow. Just confessing and praising. Wow. Like that. Just confessing and praising. Wow. Just confessing and praising. Wow. So the confession, just confessing to attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. And praising is just accepting universal blanket praising for all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. That's a mouthful. Fortunately, I've been working on this so diligently for so long that I was able to bring this through this morning and work on it throughout the day and get it set in stone, so to speak, for everyone. That's my job, like a spiritual composer, composing this confessional praising style that we have, so that everyone then can work at it, can impress themselves. It's all about impressing yourself, not about impressing someone else. Are you impressing yourself? So being able to get this and put it into context, that impresses. I've impressed myself with that. I'm really impressed by this. It's like, wow, you know, great job. I say to myself, what a great job. And I'm really fired up about it. That's what's important. I'm not thinking about what do other people think. If I don't think that I did a great job, what good is other people telling me I have? I'm still not going to believe it, you know, and then I'm at the mercy of their opinion of me. We don't want to be at the mercy of other people's opinions of ourselves, right? So we want to make sure that we done something that impresses ourselves. So we say just confessing, attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. And accepting universal blanket praising for all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity, fearing. Wow. Okay, that's impressive. That's impressive. It's impressive we have this confessional praising style. Confessing and praising style. Confessing and praising style. Wow. Confessing and praising style. Wow. So first we confess and then we praise. So it's confessional praising style. First we confess and then we praise. First we confess and then we praise. First we confess, then we praise. First we confess and then we praise. Wow. Very, very, very helpful and auspicious as we go into this Labor Day and the summer. And wow, what a summer it's been. What a nerve-wracking summer it's been. Wow. We're doing, hope everyone's doing great, doing really well in the Bay Area here as far as the bug is concerned. We're doing extremely well here, way better than I think most anybody expected. And people are getting pretty complacent, I'll tell you that. So we're just hoping that it keeps trending in a positive direction here. But whatever, come what may, there's many other challenges ahead too. So we just, in this confessional praising style, wow. Just confess and praise. We confess what our troubles are, you know, how we got into just confessing attribution error, continuity fear, and false hope habiting. Yeah, that's my trouble, right? And now to remedy this, we say, and just loving, universal blanket praising of all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Okay, so this is the praise style. Wow. So we're just confessing and praising here. Confessing and praising. Confessional praising style. Our confessional praising style. And just having a wonderful, tremendous new perspective like this, an approach, that in itself is very impressive. It should impress everyone. And that's important to impress yourself right now and say, hey, I'm worthwhile. I'm an impressive being. I'm a very impressive being, actually. I'm not someone who's subject to failure, you know, to be dragged down into continual, you know, failure here. What is that? No, I'm much, much better than that, actually. And in a profound sense here, we have this tremendously exalted approach, confessional praising approach. Wow. Just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. And universal blanket praising for all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Again, so we'll go over and over and over and hear this. It's like, wow. Now, it's new, so we're kind of holding onto our breath, like thinking like, it's like anytime something's new, I kind of like hold my breath and say like, I hope nothing happens. But then, you know, at some point we'll get used to it, and it's much, that'll be much more fluid and much more wonderful. But it is initially when we turn a corner. Anytime you're turning a corner, it's a very significant turning of a corner. You're kind of like, what's around the corner kind of thing. And so it is a challenge for sure. But we're up for the challenge here. We're up for the challenge. So we don't condemn ourselves. No condemnation of anything whatsoever. Universal blanket praising of all pretending. Everything in this universe is mere pretense. It's just life-suffering performance art is what it is. Arting. Life performance. Life-suffering performance arting. Wow. Just shocked by life-suffering performance arting. Wow. It's all performance art. It's really not even a universe. It's just performance art. Life-suffering performance art is what's going on. We're pretending this whole thing is performance art, what we're doing here. And everybody's doing, you know, extraordinary performance art here, actually. Extraordinary. Everyone. So don't condemn not even a single person here, not even a single action, nothing. We condemn zero condemnation from us here, zero condemnation, absolutely zero condemnation. That doesn't mean that there's certain things that we, you know, irritate us, we don't like or something. But when that happens, we need to just forget it and say, hey, and go back to our confessing, praising style of practicing. And really just feel this, universal blanket praising for all pretending. Here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow, like this. So this is this wonderful tool that we now have with us here, going into the last third of 2021. And this puts us in a very, very good position. I asked, coming home from work today, I asked, what should I do? Should I go practice golf or should I tape? And right away, there was an obvious tell in the world. Taping. Got to do your taping. That's extremely important right now. Extremely important. So I put that ahead, you know, first, put that ahead of everything. We'll do our practicing some other time, not right now, not today. Maybe I'm too tired. Yeah, it's been a long, stressful work week, for sure. And these times have been nerve-wracking, for sure. And getting this new style in place here has been very, very taxing on my nerves. It's challenging, not bad. I enjoy it, but very exhausting, challenging, and exhausting. Because you just say, oh my gosh, you know, it's do or die. You know, what's going to happen? So now we have this just praise. It's confessional praying and confession and praising style. Wow, confessional and praising style. Our cap. The capists, confessional and praising style. We got our cap on here. And we wear these caps. We're wearing this cap. It's confessional and praising style caps. Wow. All in caps. Confessional and praising style. Wow. Confessional and praising style. Wow. Just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. And delighting in universal blanket praising for all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Just like that. So it's a wonderful declaration. So let this be like a challenge that you get it. You know, get it this Labor Day, get this down, get it down. So something you can say, hey, I really impressed myself by doing something I didn't think I could do. I thought it would be too difficult, and I did it. So that's what's really key is you see something like, oh, I should quit. This is too, I'm scared. Like, I don't know what's going on. I can't do this. And then you keep working at it, and you keep working at it. Maybe the most difficult thing you've ever done in your life, but you succeed. And then you're just like, hey, I'm a boss. You know, I'm some kind of boss to be able to do that. You know, that's really impressive. And then that's how you advance is you impress yourself. No other way. Reading a book by someone else and say, well, that person's really impressive. That's not good enough at all. It's not good enough at all. You might say, well, I was able to read the book. That's impressive. That is something. Yeah. But so you need to do things that seem like, wow, this might be really difficult. I don't know. And then just find a way to do it. And they say, did it. I did it. Wow, what a great step that is. Very, very impressive. And then we become less dependent on other people's opinions. I mean, if I was dependent on other people's opinions of me, how could I possibly do any of this? Because I don't have anybody directly supporting this, what I'm saying at all. I mean, I look around, is there any support, spiritual support anywhere from any spiritual? No, there isn't. Nothing. Every time I try to, you know, share this with some spiritual teachers or people, I just get, brushed off. There's no support for that in there. So, so I can't put too much stock in any of the opinions of the world at all, to do this. That is for sure. Confessional and praising style, just confessional and praising style. Here we have a confessional and praising style. Wow, just loving confessional and praising styling. Wow, just allowing confessional and praising styling. Wow, just accepting confessional and praising styling. Wow, just delighting in confessional and praising styling. Wow, just loving confessional and praising styling. Wow, just abiding in confessional and praising styling. Wow, just confessional and praising styling. Wow, just confessional and praising styling. Wow, I was doing great vocalizing today driving along, and some was doing Dion in the morning, and I saw this like a 1967 Volkswagen van go by, and there's some person who lives around here in the area, and he has two surfboards on top of the van, but they're bolted onto the van. I saw him once, and I asked him, he said, oh yeah, I bolt these on, they're always on. I said, wow, it's a really cool look though. I mean, the van's just super, super cherry. And it brings back, you know, 1967-ish type of feeling, or the late 60s, early 70s. Everybody, the coolest thing in the world was to have a VW van and be driving up and down the California coast with your surfboards. I mean, that was, we thought we were like the coolest people have ever lived, actually, at that point in time. And so I saw him driving in front of me. I said, wow. I said, hey, I need to switch over to the Beach Boys. I said, it would be cool if I drove up next to him and opened the window with like the Beach Boys, like Surfing Safari on or something. So I changed listening to the Beach Boys, 50 Greatest Hits. And even, unfortunately, I didn't catch up to him. But then he starts harmonizing, you know, with the Beach Boys. And it was like, wow. It was really fantastic. And then Surfer Girl came out in my room and stuff. And I was like, just doing this wonderful harmonizing with stuff I'd never heard before. It made the song sound different and beautiful. And every time I do it differently, and it's a different type of shade of beauty, right? It's like shades and tones of beauty that are just always a little different. And it's so refreshing for your ears to hear this. And I also did a first today in driving. I wanted to hear ENIAC's From Out of Nowhere remixes of Jeff Lynne's ELO From Out of Nowhere album, which is 10 gems of a song. And then he remixed them and just he reset music by doing that. He reset music. People don't realize it, but I sure do. It's a major musical reset that he did. He's able to use, you know, the pop format of a nice, beautiful songs, and then put this incredible sound, wall of sound of electronic but beautifully sounding stuff, and put it all together, and so it sounds beautiful and meshes so perfectly. It is just like you never heard anything like it before. I've never heard anything like it. It's just it's the next big thing, actually, in music to do that. He didn't sacrifice the beauty of the melody and the vocals and everything like that. No, it's just everything complements each other, except the sounds that he's doing electronically are just like you've never heard these sounds before. You know, and it's like, wow. But maintaining beautiful tempo, and it seems it just sounds gorgeous. And I never been able to hear it in a car car sound system or a vehicle sound system before, because I don't have unlimited data on my phone, so I can't play the YouTube videos that you put them out on YouTube, ENIAC, ENIAC channel. And so I said, what the heck? Let me burn some data here. I got to hear this music and I cranked it up to the 65, whatever, go 61, you know, full blast, 10 on 10 in there. And then it played the YouTube songs, went through a bunch of his songs, and it was mind blowing. And it sounded different than on headphones. It sounded better, you know, in some ways. It richer. I mean, it's more spacious, and I have a really the sound system that I have. It just came with it, but it sounds great. It sounds really great, and this music just sounded fabulous today. Wow. Oh, just better than expected. Better than expected. I heard all sorts of stuff that he was doing that I hadn't heard before. And I said, are you kidding me? this guy is a musical genius. You know, he's like Bach or something. I mean, he's up there with the greatest musical geniuses in history. He's just an incredible composer, actually. And to remix the stuff and do what he does is just like, wow. So that was really terrific. And then harmonizing with the Beach Boys and stuff, driving around and harmonizing, is like, wow. Surfer Girl came on, and I haven't harmonized for a long time for some reason, and I did something very different with Surfer Girl, completely changed the sound of the song. Never been able to do that before. It just changed the whole sound. It became something different but wonderful, you know, wonderful. And I was just like, wow. That is, it's amazing what adding a harmonizing voice can do when you do different stuff. It changes the sound of the song, but you can make it, you know, maybe not better, but just as good, but different. So it's like another flavor of ice cream, so to speak. It's like, isn't it great to have a lot of flavors of ice cream? And I don't want to talk about ice cream. I'm eating cottage cheese and carrot sticks now. Yeah, and grapefruit juice. That's trying to just stick to that. Got to drop some weights this autumn, right? Don't want to go into December really heavy, right? Nobody does. You want to be real, real thin as you go into December and January, because that's when usually people eat too much, right? Yeah, the pecan pie and stuff. That's always a problem. So, confessional and praising styling. Well, just confessional and our confessing and praising style. Wow, we just love our confession and praising style. Wow, just loving our confession and praising style. Wow, just loving our perfect confession and praising styling. Wow. So we have this confession and praising style. Confess attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. And just loving, universal, blanket praising of all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. So we've got something here. Going into the last third of this year, we've really got something here. And you just have to make it your own, but through impressing yourself. Through impressing yourself, and at least do the confession, you know, get part of it, just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow, just like that. Wow, just shocked by confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow, just allowing confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow, just accepting confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. Just delighting in confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. Just loving confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. Just abiding in confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. Just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening. Wow. Like that. So that's our 7-step familiarity practice. That when we want to get familiar with something, which is what's all important, that's what wins, we do our 7-step familiarity practice. Pump the light up. 7-step familiarity practice. This is what we do. When we get an insight, a clarification, something important, we just slot it right into this 7-step familiarity practice. That's our hallmark, really. This is what we are known for, is this 7-step familiarity practice. Just confessing and praising styling, wow. Just shocked by confessing and praising styling, wow. Just allowing confessing and praising styling, wow. Just accepting confessing and praising styling, wow. Just delighting in confessing and praising styling, wow. Just loving confessing and praising styling, wow. Just abiding in confessing and praising styling, wow. Just confessing and praising styling, wow. Just confessing and praising styling. Wow. Just confessing and praising styling. Wow. Just confessing and praising styling. Wow. Like that. So we will see. We will see how it goes. We will see how it goes. you know, it's so it just impress yourself. Like doing the familiarity practice, seven-step familiarity practicing. Wow. Our seven-step familiarity practicing. Wow. You know, for sure know how to do that. Know how to do that and know how to do the confession. And then you can also make the praise practice there. And just know these three-part confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just 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 confessing, praising, and practice. Just shocked by confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just allowing, confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just accepting, confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just delighting in confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just loving, confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just abiding in confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing and practice, confessing and practicing. Wow. Just confessing, praising, 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 and practicing. Wow. Like that. And you know, just stay with this. Reinforce until it becomes familiar territory. It's just like you move to a new place. It's everything's different. Everything's unfamiliar. And you just have to live there and function there and pay attention and try to dial in your surroundings and stuff. And after a while, you know, you just suddenly to the point you realize, oh, this seems pretty familiar to me. And then you relax. As you relax, you say, oh, yeah, okay, I can function here. I can function here. But I wouldn't want to be moving right now while we're doing this. It's good to be in a familiar place. So I've stayed basically in the same place my whole life. I've been here my whole life. And it's such a familiar place to me. I don't have to struggle with trying to get familiar with my surroundings. So I'm able to struggle with getting familiar with this confessing and praising styling. Wow. That's a huge effort because that's so unfamiliar to the world. So unfamiliar, actually. Super unfamiliar. So if I was traveling around and trying to get used to new places, I wouldn't be able to give this the kind of attention that it deserves at all. It wouldn't be possible. But here, I'm just super used to my surroundings. It's all that I've ever known, really. And so now I can tackle something that nobody's really used to at all. Nobody's used to this. So that's the great benefit of just being hanging out here. I love it. I love this place. So not really, it's not a problem. Fortunate, really a blessing, you know, to live in one of the best places in the world for sure, South Bay Area, California, and just be able to stay here continuously my whole life. That's a super, super, super blessing. Where would I want to even go to, actually? Otherwise. So just confessing and praising, styling. Wow, just confessing and pressing, confessing, pressing, confessing, praising, and confessing, pressing, styling. Wow, practicing, confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, confessing, praising, and practicing, styling. Wow, confessing and praising and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, 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 and practicing. Wow. So it's really helpful to impress yourself right now, and having this new style is an extremely impressive, something very, very, very impressive. And when people talk about their confidence and how do they get through times like these, you need to impress yourself. You need to feel like, you know, you're doing something that is really, really significant and very helpful. And then you're not going to panic. You're not going to panic. Say, I can work at this. I can work at this. I'm already starting to get dialed into this. And it really helps to get into something new during a period like this, which is so problematical. You know, it's like new hope that we have. And we feel like, wow, you know, all is not lost. You know, maybe the world's having such trouble, but It hasn't run up upon this yet, has it? The world? No, it hasn't. No, it hasn't. It's never been faced with this: a confessional praising and practicing style. Wow, interesting. And our confession and our praising is in practicing is extraordinary. It's extraordinary. Who confesses attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope happening? Wow. And who says, you know, just loving, universal blanket praising of all pretending, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fear. Ing. Who does that? Who has that inging style? Just inging style. Who has the seven step? You know, who is, no, it's very, 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 very new fashion, very new fashion, very new fashion. And admittedly, you know, a fashion does give us a pickup. It does give us a pickup. It does give us a pickup. It makes us feel like, you know, we're not stuck. 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 So it kind of gives us a little edge. It kind of gives us, this certainly gives us an edge, huge edge, actually. And so we have this confessing, praising, and practicing about, just 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 confessing, just shocked by confessing, praising, and practicing about, just allowing confessing, praising, and practicing about, just accepting confessing, praising, and practicing about, just delighting in confessing, praising, and practicing about, just loving confessing, praising, and practicing about, just abiding in confessing, praising, and practicing about, just confessing, praising, and practicing about, just confessing, confessing, just confessing, praising, and practicing about. I got ahead of myself because I was going to harmonize like woo woo doop doop woo ah ah bum 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 bum. it's like it's vocalizing, which I love. I love to vocalize, so I like doing this, being able to do this, just confession, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. It's interesting in vocalizing. You got to look at your mood and get in the different moods too. Sometimes like really laid back mood, really, you know, soft mood. And sometimes it's like a go-go mood, like Little Honda. Go! Different moods. Just get into different moods, and then your vocals are going to be different. It's like, ah, this is nice. Like Surfer Girls, very like, woo, woo. You're just a really soft breeze mood. It's like a soft breeze mood. Wow. And so keep that mood in your vocalizing. But then you can, you know, play with it a little bit this way and that way, and whew, a little more breezes, this breeze here and that breeze. Wow. But keep it nice and soft and breezy, so to speak, like that. Yeah. So just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing attribution, error, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. Wow. And delighting in universal blanket praising for all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Just like that. So it's been a good day. I found some diet root beer in plastic bottles. Yeah. Ice cold diet root beer on a hot summer day. It's going to heat up in the 90s this weekend here. So at least I have some of those in the refrigerator. I could go to that. And, you know, eating the cottage cheese and carrot sticks, it tastes great. Small curd cottage cheese and carrot sticks. Wow, that tastes wonderful. Love it. And then wash it down with grapefruit juice. So that's a really nice way to go. Yeah. Breakfast would be like toast with butter, peanut butter, and bananas on the top of the peanut butter, and then some strawberry jam on top, something like that. Delicious. Delicious. And then try not to eat after 6 o'clock, you know, 6 to 6 type of thing. That helps you. If you want to lose some pounds, that's a nice thing to do this next 4 months. I mean, set some goals for yourself. Like, hey, let's impress ourselves with learning this confessional, praising and practicing style. Let's lose some pounds. Yeah, let's start doing some great stuff. A four month intensive here. Let's have a 4 month intensive where we do some great stuff and we impress ourselves. So it's 4 months of impressing ourselves here. You know, that's winning. That's winning. You have to go for the win right now. Okay, the way the world's going, you have to go for the win. Okay, just not treading water anymore. We're going for the win. And that in itself is ennobling, And but just this blanket praising, past, present, and future, here, there, and everywhere. Now, when we're already praising all possible pretensions, all of them, already praised, what do we need the future for? We've already praised it. So it puts us in this timeless position automatically. Here, there, and everywhere, it puts us in this intrinsic spacious condition. We don't have to go anywhere particular because we know it's exactly the same spaciously here as anywhere else. We've already praised all pretend places. We're pretending we're here, we're pretending we're there, and all pretensions that we could ever come up with in the future. So there's no point. We're released from the future. We've already praised it. Completely praised. It's complete. Our future is already completely praised. All places, all types of pretensions, already completely praised. And so there's nothing to discriminate one way or the other. So the mind just, there's a lot of us, that settles down. When we're not worried about the future or any judgment or condemnation or any of that stuff, we're accepting just universal blanket praising for all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future. Wow. Okay, so that has some tremendous positive side effects by doing this. Is we will start to feel more and more timeless, and time space does not matter to us anymore. We've already dealt with it properly. We've simply just praised it all. Universal blanket praising. Praised it all, past, present, future, here, there, and everywhere. We've praised it all already. So that's our position. It's just all praise to all pretending. All praise to all pretending, wow. Just all praise to all pretending, wow. Just shocked by all praise to all pretending, wow. Just allowing all praise to all pretending, wow. Just accepting all praise to all pretending, wow. Just delighting in all praise to all pretending, wow. Just loving all praise to all pretending, wow. Just abiding in all praise to all pretending, wow. Just all praise to all pretending, wow. Just all praise to all pretending, wow. See, just all praise to all pretending, wow. So everyone's totally noble, noble divine beings that are simply pretending because they're too afraid to stop pretending. And much of the pretending that's going on is we're pretending that we can't stop pretending. And that's an attempt to get rid of the continuity fear. We're saying if we can't stop pretending, what are we worried about not being able to function if we stop pretending? We can't stop pretending, therefore we shouldn't have any worry about that at all. And so this is a tricky way we're trying to resolve the situation. It's a false hope habit. But that's one of the major false hope habits that we have, is we're pretending that we can't stop pretending. We're pretending that we can't stop pretending. Okay, it's a false hope habit. So we certainly don't want to keep doing that. We certainly don't want to reinforce that. And that's what the world is reinforcing. What the world is reinforcing for everyone now on an unprecedented scale, totally unprecedented scale right now, is reinforcing false hope habits. That's what the world is doing right now. And we think that's beneficial. Most people think like, wow, how great this world is. To tell you that, you know, to just be blunt about it, we're in like the worst time in history right now. We people think we're in some great age now. We're in the worst age ever. Of this world. It's the worst time ever in this world, actually, because we have unprecedented amplification and pressure towards reinforcing our false hope habits. unprecedented pressure and reinforcement of and that's as bad as it gets. That's what's terrible. So we're not in a wonderful age. We're in the worst age ever right now. And these times are going to be the most difficult times in history, no question about it. By far and away the most difficult times in history. So it's not a nice time. We're living in the worst of times right now. And again, what makes the times terrible is reinforcing false hope habits. That's what makes things terrible. And the world is really just going totally all in on this, totally all in on this. So this is extremely worrisome, which is why this help is here. I mean, this has all been foreseen. And so I've been training and working so I could be of use during these times and help, you know, galvanize this confessing, praising, and practice discipline that we have to more than offset all of this, more than offset all of it. And so we're just, again, we've already praised everywhere and every when. Here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future. Blanket, universal blanket praising of all pretending. All pretending is extraordinary, actually. It's performance art. Life-suffering performance arting is going on. And it's all extraordinary. It's so difficult to pretend to be sick, to pretend to have needs, to pretend to be a body, pretend to be suffering, to pretend to be aging, pretend to be dying, pretend to be victimized, pretend to be suffering in any which way at all. That is extreme, takes extreme dedication, dedication to pretending and all sorts of psychological defense mechanisms to enable us to do this. Actually, it's extraordinarily difficult for any of us to even imagine pretend that these roles that we're in. It's a brilliant act. You know, it's brilliant. It's brilliant. It's ineffective. It's not necessary and it's ineffective, but it's still brilliant. And so certainly we praise our own brilliance. Certainly, we don't condemn our own brilliance at all. We praise it. We praise it and confess that it's, you know, insufficient. It's insufficient based on attribution error, which is a false premise, based on an unforeseen problem of getting used to pretending, and then based on that and then and lack of, you know, the severity of it so bad that we then use false hope habits to ineffectually try to deal with it. But yet everything we do here is entirely brilliant, really. It's entirely brilliant performance arting here by everyone. Absolutely it is. So it's totally praiseworthy. Everyone here is totally praiseworthy, no matter how it seems to us. You know, it's just keep in mind, it's extremely difficult to imagine any of these roles we're doing. It's just an astonishing accomplishment on our part, brilliant accomplishment on our part, but totally unnecessary, okay? Totally unnecessary, and totally ineffectual, okay? That's also true. Both of these are true. But again, the brilliance is there everywhere. The whole universe is our life art is a brilliant life performance art. This universe, brilliant performance art. Okay, so absolutely we should praise ourselves for this. 100% praise, entire universal blanket praising for all pretending. Wow, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future. Wow, and just accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fear. So the Holy Spirit is what actually resolves our continuity fear by this exquisitely charming painting that it paints upon the canvas of our praise. Our praise produces this exquisite canvas that then the Holy Spirit then paints upon this canvas, this picture, that's exquisitely charming picture. Wow. And then that restores our confidence in ourselves that we can function without pretending. That's how it works. That's how it works. So that's just winding down here and going towards dusk in a beautiful California day, of course, though, smoky air, but it's still beautiful. It's really nice performance arting out here, but it's brilliant. It's brilliant performance arting out here, but it's brilliant all over the world. Everything is brilliant. Every stone is brilliant performance arting. Every leaf is brilliant performance arting. You know, everything that we see is praiseworthy, absolutely praiseworthy for its brilliance. It's also totally unnecessary and totally ineffective, futile. It's unnecessary and futile. Okay, everything. unnecessary and futile, but our brilliance is there, and that's the important part, because that helps restore our confidence that we can function in reality. We need to prepare ourselves to accept the Holy Spirit's beautiful, exquisitely charming remedy for the continuity exquisitely charming remedy for continuity fearing, in that we just, that will restore our confidence that we can function without pretending. This is what the goal for everyone is. So, you know, we don't need to worry about the world too much. Whatever happens, we're praising it. We're praising it. It's absolutely brilliant. Total brilliance. This whole universe, absolute brilliance, performance arting. Wow. Zero condemnation. So this is a huge departure from the way the world is going, right? The world is going towards crucifixional attitude right now to an extreme extent. I just had to tune it out because it was just getting in the way of turning the corner here, because it's really going towards this extraordinary crucifixional attitude. Holy cow. And that's doubling down on bad habits, of course. False hope habiting, doubling down on that. And all that does is delay, right? Double down on bad false oath habiting equals delay in severe fear and struggle, you know, just feeling just stuck, going around in circles and feeling pretty much like hypnotized and in kind of a what you call it, stunned hypnotic state. Most people go around and look like they're stunned, you know, stunned in a hypnotic state. Just like, I don't even know what I am, what I'm doing. I don't know. I'm just trying to, you know, the clarity is just not there. It's just not there. It's just not inging. It's just not inging here. And just to see, I look at everybody. I see everybody. I feel so sorry for everyone, really. It's just terrible because I just see that they just feel like they have no options. You know, they're just stuck in false hope habiting, so severely stuck. Doesn't have to be that way. So just confessing, practice, praising, and practicing well. Just confessing, praising, and practicing well. Just confessing, praising, and practicing well. Just confessing, praising, and practicing well. Impress yourself, wow. Impress yourself, wow. Impress yourself, wow. Impress yourself, wow. That's the key. Impress yourself, but in a real profound way, to start to dial into this confessing, praising, and practicing style that we have, to dial into this fresh approach, to start dialing into this. You know, this is going to give you a huge, huge feel like, you know, I'm part of something here, you know, that is very impressive. Very, very impressive. And I don't have to get upset with the world anymore. Our discipline here is universal blanket praising, all pretending. Brilliant, 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 brilliant. Everything here is brilliant performance arting, life suffering performance arting. Wow, just loving brilliant life, just praising brilliant life suffering performance arting. Wow, here, okay. So everyone you see walking down the street, they're doing a brilliant job of life suffering performance arting. Brilliant job, brilliant job. All of this is totally brilliant. It's also unnecessary and futile. Yeah, but there's no condemnation here. I mean, but still, our heart's in it, and brilliant, and our heart's in it, and dedication, and you know, it's so creatively clever what we've done, and all of this. So, just universal blanket praising for all pretending. Wow. Here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future. We're praising the future right now. Praising everywhere right here, praising the future right now. Praising all time, praising everywhere right here, praising all time right now. So there never can be a time where we're not, that hasn't already been praised by us here. We're praising all time, past, present, and future, and there can never be a place that we haven't already praised. So we already praised everywhere, every place, and every time. Just universal blanket praising, okay? Universal blanket praising of all pretending, everywhere and every win. You could say everywhere and every win. Everywhere and every win. Wow. Here, there, and everywhere. Past, present, and future. Everywhere and every win. Wow. The only trouble I have is when I finish with this, then I like, what do I do now? And then I say, well, let me look and see if anyone else is tuned into this. And I look, and nothing. It's like, oh my gosh, I shouldn't even look. Shouldn't even bother looking now. So I just make some graphics and stuff and put some of these quotes in there, you know, post it on Facebook and nobody looks at it. But at least it's reinforcing, you know, reinforcing my own commitment here, which is great. So just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow, just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Hey, yeah. Somebody's trying to text me. What is this? What is this? It's just spam. It's just spam. It is just spam entirely. Can I get rid of this? No. Hey. Wow. There you go. That was difficult. How do these people, you know, they get your number and they text you? Yeah, it's like, what can you do, right? Just praising. Well, just praise it. Just praise. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. So all praise to the brilliance of spam, right? All praise to the brilliance of the spammers. Wow. Just universal praise, blanket praising of all pretending. So all praise to the spammers. Wow. All praise to the hackers. Wow. All praise to the tech people. Wow. All praise to the politicians. Wow. All praise to everybody. Wow. All praise to all pretending. Wow. All praise to all pretending. Wow. We've done a fantastic job. This collective life art, life performance arting, life suffering performance arting, this collective performance art that we've been able to produce as this universe is our collective life suffering performance arting. Wow. And it's absolutely praiseworthy, every last bit of it, every leaf of it. But that's just a third. We confess, we praise, and then we practice. So we don't just get lost in praise. We have three aspects to what we're doing. Confessing, praising, and practicing. Confessing, praising, and practicing. So we stay very balanced in this way. Very balanced. I mean, there have been praise movements before. And it becomes, you know, it tends to somehow, you know, I would say it's better to have it balanced out like this. So you need to confess and be clear about how do we get in this situation? Why are we here? You know, this continuity fear and what's going on. So the confession and clarification of that, and then praising and then practicing, getting familiar, our familiarity practice. So we have three aspects here and we keep them balanced. There'll be times when you feel stronger in confessing, times you feel stronger in praising, times you'll feel stronger in practicing. But we keep juggling all three like that. Keep them going like that, yeah. Whew. Wow, 107. Really, how we get there? I don't know. Yeah. So very significant. This Labor Day, very significant. Very, very, very significant. There's going to be a new phase in the world now. There's going to be a new phase going forward, and it's going to be, I believe it's going to be rather alarming, actually, quite alarming. And so we don't want to get caught up in that. We're not getting caught up in that. We're simply praising every, you know, universal blanket mean covering all, universal blanket praising, just not pick and choose. I'm praising this and not that or that. No, it's just blanket, universal blanket praising, covers everything without exception. So get this feeling that we're just covering everything without exception. Our praise just is just covering everything without exception. Not one single exception. That makes it easy on us, doesn't it? We don't have to be thinking like, shall I accept this? Or why am I accepting this? Or how about I accept something else? No exceptions at all. Just blanket praising. Universal blanket praising. Wow. Just 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 universal blanket praising. Wow. And so I'm glad I kept my voice here. I didn't do too much vocalizing. Light today. Light. Sometimes I get carried away and do it for hours, and my voice gets kind of fried. But sometimes I can go for like almost like a week straight if my voice is good before it finally gets really tired. Boy, I remember when I was playing guitar, how I'd practice like crazy. I never stopped practicing. But finally, I started stopping and giving myself a break. I might like take some time off. And then I'd come back to the guitar, and it's like, wow. And I'd just be playing. It would sound so great. I said, I can't believe it. I said, this is me? Wow. But then I'd play like for hours and hours and hours and hours. And then the next day, I'd play hours and hours. And then I'd start getting tired again, and then it wouldn't sound so good anymore. I'd lose that edge to it, the sparkle to it, you know. And then I'd then stop again for a while, and then get back in the same kind of thing. But gradually, you know, it's just like it's too difficult. I want something that sparkles all the time. But unfortunately, with guitar, you know, you see like the best players, and they sound really great and stuff. But you know, I guarantee it to them, a lot of the times they don't think they're playing great. They're like tired. It wears you out. And same with singing. And so if they take a break and they go back to the guitar, then they're rewarded with just like, they just feel like, wow, I can do no wrong. I can do no wrong here whatsoever. Holy cow. I'm just on it. I've got that extra edge to everything. And that makes that sort of that sparkle to it. So the life of a musician is rough, tough. It almost never satisfied. Almost never satisfied. You say, wow, I remember, you know, when that time I sounded just great, but I don't sound nearly that great right now. Well, how can I get back to that? And you struggle, and you may never get back to it. Maybe it just been a time where it was just optimal. Everything was optimal. And you were just on top of the world, and you were so relaxed and confident and refreshed and everything, and everything was right. And it just, you say, if only I could sound like this forever. And then all sorts of stuff happens, and you get busy doing this, and emergencies happen, and stress here and there, and all things happen, and then you try to come back, and it doesn't have the same sound to it. Doesn't have the same sound. Wow. That's why it's nice listening to these groups in the past, like the Beach Boys and Dion and various groups that, you know, different times in history. Dion and the Beach Boys were both before the assassination of President Kennedy in, I think, November, 22nd or something around there, 1963. It was before that. It was before that. And then the next year, I think it was Martin Luther King got assassinated, and Robert Kennedy got assassinated. And that was more like in 68-ish or something. But things were not the same after, you know, Kennedy got assassinated. They were not the same at all. No way. So the Dion and the Beach Boys and Elvis, I was born the year I was born, 1956. Elvis had like the top three hits, I think, of that year, and the fifth, and the, you know, he had like all sorts of great hits that year. Elvis Presley was king of those times, the year I was born, and it continued on for a while, but he was in the top of his game. Jailhouse Rock was, I think, number one or something. Don't Be Cruel, and, you know, everybody was mad for Elvis. That's the year I was born. I was born into that, and then Dion was like late 50s, I think. His first 57, 58, first song came out, I think. When I Wonder Why, I think, came out, 58, maybe, 57, 58. And then he went up to 1960, 62, 63, maybe around there. And then the Beach Boys came in 63, 64. And then the Beatles, you know, were soon after them, 64, 65, I believe, you know, they became enormous, but that was after Kennedy's assassination in November of 1963, that the whole world changed. It changed so fast. I remember that still. I was in the kitchen, and listening to transistor radio. I was right in this, right here where I live right now, same house, listening. I think I was listening to that, and they were announcing that, you know, President Kennedy, we didn't have TV, so we heard on the radio, President Kennedy had just, you know, been assassinated. And I remember my, you know, just my parents were just, just shocked. Everyone was shocked out of their minds. The adults were just stunned and shocked and beside themselves with concern, extreme concern. It was, I just like, wow, something, the whole world, something just terrible happened to beyond my comprehension. And from that point, from then the Beatles came, and that was escapism, I mean, the Beach Boys put out the Surfer Girl album in September, I think, of 63. And so we were all just grooving on the Beach Boys here in California. It was just like, life was just fantastic. Really, it was, this wonderful summer, and then the autumn was great. And remember drinking juice drinks and ice cubes and t-shirts and shorts and bare feet. And we were just, life was wonderful. And then Kennedy assassination happened, and suddenly everybody became very serious and said, what the heck's going on here? And who did it? Who's behind this? Is there going to be a coup? And this paranoia, and it never was the same after that. And then the Beatles came along, and people used that as like, just a way of the kids to just get with something new, get with something new. They just had to have something new that came after the Kennedy assassination. The Beach Boys were pre that, they wanted something that was new that they could grab a hold of. And they just did like crazy. It became a mania. There's no way to explain really very well what the Beatles were like. It was Beatle mania, and that is an apt term for it. I mean, the girls especially went out of their minds. Anyway, I just put this together now. It was because of the extreme stress we were under as a country, United States, West, the whole world was scared. Like the United States, what's going to happen? And then, just as like an escapism, it was just escapism. Ah, something just out of this world. The Beatles came along, and the Beatles were absolutely fantastic. You could say the greatest group of all time, and that'd probably be very accurate. They were just magical. Still are magical. I listen to the songs, just, oh my God, that just nothing like them before or since. It's just, I love 8 days a week for some reason. They don't like it. The Beatles didn't like it. They said, that's not good enough. I said, what are you talking about? That's fantastic. Funny. But it's just that, you just got into a different mood with the Beatles, right? And you just put your cares aside, and it's just love, 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 and all you need is love. So people channeled all their efforts into the Beatles, into music and stuff, to try to escape the really extreme concern in the United States that there was a military-industrial complex that was really running the country, the alphabet agencies, military-industrial complex, perhaps aliens, who was behind this whole thing? Was it Russia, the Cold War? I mean, people were just like, says, what's going to... We're freaking out. And then along came the Beatles, and the kids just jumped on it because it's something new. So we're talking about here something new, to just get with something new. It's powerful. It's really so powerful here to get with something new. And this is, we really have something new here. We really have this wonderful just confessing, praising, and practicing. Confessing, praising, and practicing style. And we're bringing in this attribution, air, continuity, fear, and false hope habiting. And the world has never heard this before. The world has never heard this kind of spiritual talk, this style of talking before. It really has not. Attribution, air, who's ever talked about that? No one. Continuity, fear, who's really talked about that? Jesus a little bit mentioned that we're afraid that we might not be able to function. That's tremendous. And so continuity, fear, and then false hope habiting, which hasn't really been talked about too much directly. So this is, it's a little bit, it's got some little, just like the Beatles had a little something of the past, like the Everly Brothers. The Beatles worship the Everly Brothers, who just passed on. The Everlys are no more, but they were amazing harmony. The Beatles just loved them and listened to them. And said, we want to sound like the Everly Brothers. Dick Clark wouldn't play the Beatles on American Bandstand to start with because he says, this is an Everly Band copycat. It's like Everly Brothers copycat. I'm not going to promote that. So at first he passed on the Beatles, but the Beatles were just out of this world, out of this world. You just emotionally, you know, there's just been never not been anything like it. Still, the feel is still there. It's still there. I can tune into it. It's still there. Yeah, it's just this. Turn on that transistor radio instead of Kennedy being all these assassinations. We got the, you know, the Beatles. And so many albums coming out, so many new songs coming out all the time, right? New Beatles song, a new Beatles song. This went on for years. New Beatles song just came out. Wow. Everybody's freaking out and said, oh my God, listen to this, a new album, you know, then Sgt. Pepper's came out, you know, and the White Album and all these different, Rubber Soul, Revolver, you know, all these different albums came out and they're just, the songs were just to die for, just to die for. You know, they just seemed, every album came out and there was like, you know, 8 to 10 songs just to die for on those albums. It was so good. Day Tripper, Yesterday, Michelle, All My Lovin', you know, She Loves You, Help, Hard Day's Night, you know, Yellow Submarine, you know, everything going on and on and on. Eleanor Rigby, Day in the Life. Sgt. Pepper's, Hey Jude, you know, Hey Jude. But the earlier stuff, I love the earlier stuff. It was just so upbeat and swinging, and just, my God, it was amazing. So that's an example that people just turned the page. They turned the page. They said, wow, it's time to turn the page. And we've kind of had that moment right now, the way things have been going in the world. It's time to turn the page. It's time to turn the page. We realize the world's in trouble. The what's going on behind the scenes in the world is scary. It's really, really scary. It's so scary, we just got to tune it out. We just got to tune it out. We just have to tune it out and put our attention on something else that's wonderful and that we feel super hopeful. And this praise, just confessing, praising, and practicing, wow, just blanket praise for blanket, you know, universal blanket praising for all pretending, past, present, and future. Here, there, everywhere, just, we're just in this total praise mood. Just this total praise mood. Not one iota does our praise not cover. Our praise covers everything, here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future. Right now, we're praising, covering everything with our praise. Right now, this instant, just covering everything with our praise. And letting that then be an acceptance for the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Yeah. You think you lost your love? Well, I saw her yesterday. Hey, it's you she's thinking of. And she told me what to say. Hey, she said she loves you. Boom. And you know that can't be bad. Yeah, she said she loves you. And you know you can't be sad. Like that. Yeah. Like that. Like, what is that? You know, what is that? Like, what in the world? Wow. We were just like, ah. It was a whole new sound, a whole new vibe, all of this. And then, you know, people just jumped in, completely went for it, and then never looked back. It was a trouble because the Beach Boys were let lost and forgotten, basically. And Dion was too. So everything that came before was lost and forgotten, essentially, for a long time. And people just jumped on this and didn't look back. And that propelled, you know, that propelled so much stuff. It propelled the spirituality of the late 60s and the 70s. People going all over the world, you know, Beatles with Maharishi, and people said, hey, let's go to India. You know, let's escape this military-industrial complex, whatever the heck's going on. And let's just go to Kathmandu. Let's go to Nepal. Let's go, you know, let's hang out in Goa. Let's go all these, you know, and let's do the trekking, you know, the hippie trail from Europe, walking across, you know, Iran and Afghanistan and Pakistan into India, and hitchhiking hippie trail. And so people were just like people in motion. Yeah. That's that Scott McKenzie. For those who come to San Francisco, be sure to wear a flower in your hair. People in motion. For those who come to San Francisco, people wearing flowers in their hair and playing music. Everybody wanted to be the Beatles. Everybody wanted to make music. And so they said, we're just going to get into this something new here, something fresh, something hopeful. And we're at another point, another historical point where we just have to do that. We just have to do that. You know, it's just winning time. And so just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. 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 Can't do the music thing, really. It's already been done. We're not going to top the Beatles, folks. We're not going to top that, no. And all the stuff that's coming, it's so, you know, there's something different. It's not going to be a musical thing. And we've done the war thing before in history and all this stuff. Let's do this just confessing, praising and practicing thing. Confessing, praising, and practicing thing. And see what happens. Wow. See what happens. See if we can catch this new breeze. See if we can catch this new breeze. And hey, we're in this new vibe. Gotta catch those love and good vibrations happening. Gotta catch this new vibration, so to speak. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. Just confessing, praising, and practicing. Wow. So just confessing attribution, air continuity, fear, and false hope happening, wow. And delighting in universal blanket, praising of all pretending here, there, and everywhere, past, present, and future, and accepting Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity, fearing, wow. Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow, the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow, just accepting the Holy Spirit's exquisitely charming remedy for all continuity fearing. Wow. Yeah. So, we're doing our best to turn the corner. And one way or another, we'll turn the corner. Maybe there'll be a whole bunch of stuff going on in the world that's like corner turning for us, where we just, you know, catch this vibe, catch a new wave, so to speak. Yeah, catch this wave that's just like, wow, this is a different kind of wave. Love this wave. It's different. And we like it, and it gives us really tremendous hope. And we put the past behind us, you know, and just stop worrying about this or that. Let's make our own. Let's impress ourselves now. Instead of trying to be impressed with the world, let's impress ourselves. Let's stop waiting for the world to impress us. Let's impress ourselves by praising the entire universe. Praising the entire universe, past, present, and future, here, there, and everywhere. Let's impress ourselves by praising the entire universe.